In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of God our Father, who raised Jesus from the dead, be with you all. Just for those who don't know me, I'm Father Simon. I'm parish priest of St Mary Magdalene and St Martha's in Bexhill. Firstly, I'd like to welcome you to the church, though, of Our Lady Immaculate and St Michael's here in Battle. I want to thank the community here for use of the church. While it's just the worst possible moment in the life of the parish, for 3 weeks, our entire boiler system at both churches and the presbytery all failed. And the engineer is there at the moment. He's got the parts. He's very confident that it's going to solve the problem. So fingers crossed on that. So thank you for your understanding in coming up to Battle this morning. We're gathering to offer this Requiem Mass for the repose of the soul of our dear friend and brother, Michael O'Reilly. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon him. May he rest in peace. Amen. And a special welcome, of course, to Michael's family and friends. Thank you for joining us today, and not just here in the church, but via the wonders of my Apple iPhone, which is here. It's got most of the church in here, so they're joining us on Facebook Live, uniting their prayers with us. And we know that some people can't travel, of course, because of the lockdown. I believe we've got representatives also from Formwood Care Home, and we're grateful for their presence and their care of Michael. In the waters of baptism, Michael dined with Christ and rose with him to new life. May he now share with him eternal glory. Symbols of Michael's faith on his coffin, and in baptism Michael received the sign of the cross. May he now share in Christ's victory over sin and death. And in life Michael cherished the gospel of Christ. May he now hear these words of eternal life. Come, blessed of my Father. Let us pray. Almighty God and Father, it is our certain faith that your Son, who died on the cross, was raised from the dead, the first fruits of all who have fallen asleep. Grant that through this mystery, your servant Michael, who has gone to his rest in Christ, may share in the joy of his resurrection. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, for ever and ever. Amen. Are we going to listen to our first reading? Please be seated.
A reading from the prophet Isaiah. On this holy mountain, the Lord of hosts will prepare for all people a banquet of rich food. A banquet of fine wines, of food rich and juicy, of fine strained wines. On the mountains, he will remove the mourning veil covering all peoples, and the shroud enwrapping all nations. He will destroy death forever. The Lord will wipe away the tears from every cheek. He will take away his people's shame everywhere on earth, for the Lord has said so. That day it will be said, see, this is our God, in whom we have hoped for salvation. The Lord is the one in whom we hoped. We exult and we rejoice that he has saved us. For the hand of the Lord rests on this mountain. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you.
And
a reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. When the soldiers reached the place called the Skull, they crucified Jesus there, and the two criminals also, one on the right, the other on the left. One of the criminals hanging there abused him. "Are you not the Christ?" he said. "Save yourself and us as well." But the other spoke up and rebuked him. "Have you no fear of God at all?" he said. "You got the same sentence as he did, but in our case, we deserved it. We are paying for what we did. But this man has done nothing wrong." "Jesus," he said, "remember me when you come into your kingdom." "Indeed, I promise you," he replied, "today you will be with me in paradise." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise
be
to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Please be seated. We're gathering today to commend to God the soul of Michael, a man who from humble beginnings in Ireland made his way to England, but never lost sight of the true journey, his pilgrimage of faith back to the Father's house. It was a journey, as I'm sure we'll hear more of in the eulogy, that was centred on his family, on hard work, but not without its share of suffering and loss. But as a person of faith, Michael would come to understand that pain is just suffering, but when our pains and our losses are united to the person of Jesus Christ, they can become a sacrifice offered for our own good and the good of those closest to us, including the faithful departed, those who have gone before us marked with a sign of faith, those same signs of faith that a few moments ago we placed on Michael's coffin as he comes to the end of his own earthly pilgrimage. Our prayer today is that he now takes his rightful place in heaven, which the prophet Isaiah describes like a banquet of rich food and fine wine. And so although we may be gathering in sorrow for a funeral, it's our hope now that Michael is dressed in his wedding garment, and he takes his place at the supper of the Lamb. The psalmist sung for us that the Lord has spread a banquet in the sight of our foes. There's no greater foe than death. But our faith gives us the courage to sing out, "O death, where is thy sting? O grave, where is thy victory?" Therefore, the celebration of the Holy Mass is a very fitting place indeed to hold a funeral. For in the Mass, the one cross of Jesus Christ is represented before our eyes. That's the sacrifice that takes away the sins of the world and opens for us the way from death into life. And in the Holy Mass, we are given our viaticum, our food for the journey, divine nourishment, filled with the blessed sweetness of grace himself, the body, blood, soul, and divinity of our Lord Jesus Christ. And as we remember the cross and resurrection of Jesus, we give thanks for our own redemption, and we petition that Jesus remembers us now in his kingdom. And as a person of faith, this is, in effect, the prayer that Michael prayed every time he requested the sacraments. Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom. We are grateful to my assistant priest, Father Rajesh, for visiting Michael and providing him with the sacraments for the last rites, which will make his own passing over from death to life that much easier. In those rites, Michael has imitated the penitent thief. He has expressed his own sorrow for sin. He has placed his trust in the cross of Jesus Christ. And in doing so, we may be assured of that consoling response of our Lord. Today, Michael, you will be with me in paradise. So as we prepare the altar for the liturgy of the Eucharist, we'll listen to O Bread of Heaven. Stand and pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant Michael, We beseech your mercy, that he who did not doubt your Son to be a loving Saviour may find in him a merciful Judge, who lives and reigns for ever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Amen.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please kneel. If you're unable to kneel, please sit. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a peace people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with St. Michael, with St. Mary Magdalene, St. Martha, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant, Francis our Pope, and Richard our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion and merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servant Michael, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he, who was united with your son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who have died, and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters too, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages, and praise you without end. Through Christ our Lord, for whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honour is yours, for ever and ever. Amen. So let us stand, and at the Saviour's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign for ever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Once again, please kneel or sit if you're unable. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Let perpetual light shine upon Michael, with your saints forever, for you are merciful. Eternal rest grant unto Michael, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon him, with your saints forever, for you are merciful. Stewards are just going to assist us with coming up to Holy Communion safely. I'm just going to redo my hands and put my face covering on. left us in the sacrament of his body, food for the journey. Mercifully grant that, strengthened by it, our brother Michael may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated again, as our prayers now turn to those of remembrance and a tribute to Michael.
Just Christ, I do just want to say a big thank you to everybody for being with us today and to our son for your very gracious help in arranging the funeral. So thank you, Father, for that. And also to the people here at Battle Church. We're also delighted the family over to join us on Facebook or YouTube from Ireland as well. So that's a really great blessing to us. Michael was born in Barntown, County Wexford in Ireland in 1931 and was one of 10 children. Life, as for so many in rural Ireland in the 1930s, was very hard. Despite the poverty and many privations, Michael was fortunate to grow up in a loving family with the Catholic faith at its heart. The premature death of Michael's father from tuberculosis forced the family into a deeper poverty and meant that the family could no longer live together in the same house. Michael received a rudimentary and in many ways lamentable education in a school which was run by the now discredited Christian Brothers Religious Order. However, Michael was an intelligent and ambitious person, and this in due course led him to join the exodus of talented young Irish people to England in search of a better life. Michael found work with various civil engineering companies, and whilst working in East Sussex met a young woman to dance called Betty Lokes. They soon started courting, and as a prelude to their marriage, Michael completed the period of national service, which was necessary to enable him to gain British citizenship. Michael and Betty were married in the church of St Mary Magdalene in Bexhill in 1953 and began their married life living with Betty's parents in Stocks Meadow in Infield before moving to the new house in Spark Gardens, Manchester Road in Infield, which was to remain the family home until Michael entered into residential care in old age. Michael and Betty shared a deeply loving marriage of nearly 65 years in duration, in which they were irrevocably committed to each other. Family was very much at the heart of it all, and Michael and Betty were blessed with the gift of 3 surviving sons, although they sadly lost one child during late pregnancy and another immediately after birth. The children, Michael, Tim and Philip, were privileged to grow up in a home with parents who were not financially wealthy, but were rich and generous in love. Michael and Betty did everything they could to support their children and were proud of their achievements. Michael and Betty had always hoped to have a daughter, and so they were delighted in due course to welcome Lenny, Janice and Claire into their family life. As well as being wonderful parents, Michael and Betty were also superlative grandparents, and each of the grandchildren, Mark, Christopher, Henry, Jake, Harry, Henry and Ben, have found fond memories of all that they did with their granddad, including family holidays and days out, watching sport together with Grandad either on the TV, at Michael's beloved Brighton Hove Albion, or with Grandad on the touchline, at various of the grandchildren's sporting endeavours. There was also the crazy golf, which gave way to the real thing, and golf outings even included the Open Championship at Royal St George's in Sandwich. The grandchildren shared the common memory of visiting their Nan and Grandad's house, and playing with toys that had been passed down the generations, playing football and cricket at the bottom of the garden, and being fed with a variety of desirable and healthy dietary options. There were also, of course, the great-grandchildren. Michael was so pleased in his final years to spend precious moments with the great-grandchildren, Ted and Ethan, and how he would have smiled if he'd lived just a few days longer and been able to be told of the birth of Zachary, a third great-grandson. As well as their immediate family, Michael and Betty also treasured their parents and siblings, their nieces, nephews and cousins, and loved seeing them whether in Sussex or in Ireland. Michael and Betty were hospitable, generous people, always willing to share the modest amount that they had. They delighted in welcoming their own and their children's good friends into the family home, and they gladly widened the circle of their family to include Derek as an honorary member of the family. Michael worked long and hard to provide for his family, inculcating his trait in his children. spent his whole career in civil engineering and building for Natons, chiefly working at Broxbourne Plant Hire, and then at Southern Water, where he finished his career as a buildings maintenance area manager. Always a keen sportsman, Michael became a good golfer in retirement, representing the Hall and Park Golf Club in the seniors team, adding this accomplishment to his earlier Lawn Green bowling achievement of representing East Sussex at county level. Michael also had a hard tackling reputation from his youthful days on the football field. At home, Michael loved his garden and also loved whiling away the hours with Betty, indulging her love for the soaps and watching the live sport when he could get away with it. Michael was a big-hearted, compassionate, sentimental, generous, caring man with a wonderful sense of humour, which was just as well given his legendary skills at DIY, where he would always finish a project but not necessarily quite in the way that he or the manufacturers intended. Michael often said that the family were incredibly fortunate, and this was largely true up until the beginning of the second decade of the 21st century. Early in that decade, Betty began to suffer from depression and anxiety, and soon after, Michael and Betty's son Tim died following a short illness. These twin blows were too much for Michael's tender heart to bear, and he soon began to manifest the early stages of vascular dementia. This did not prevent him from remaining devotedly by Betty's side during her declining years in the nursing home, but did mercifully mean that he did not fully appreciate that his elder son Michael had also died tragically in 2016. Michael's final years were spent at Thornwood Care in Bexhill, where Michael received outstanding care from the staff team. And the family were very grateful to the staff team for their professionalism and for their compassion that they showed throughout Michael's time at Thornwood. Michael never lost the Catholic faith of his childhood. For quite a long time, he bore the scars of some of the failings of the church, which he experienced as a child and as a young adult. It led to a somewhat ambivalent relationship with the institutional church for quite a while. But the reforms of the Second Vatican Council helped him to gradually return to regular mass going for the last third of his life. We are truly grateful for that, and also we are grateful that Michael was able to receive the Holy Communion whilst at Thornwood, and finally to receive the last rites at the end of his good life. So we thank God for all that Michael means to us, and we pray that he will be granted eternal life through the mercy of God.
So just before we come to the final commendation, just once again to reiterate those thanks to the community here in Battle for their hospitality. Also just want to thank Claire, who's come up from Bexhill to be a steward today as well. So thank you, Claire. Glad that so many people hopefully have been able to join us over Facebook. The internet connection seems to have been stable, which is always a good sign. And so, my dear brothers and sisters, Michael has fallen asleep in Christ. Confident in our hope of eternal life, let us commend him to the loving mercy of our Father, and let our prayers go with him. Michael was adopted as God's son and was nourished at the table of the Lord. May he now inherit the promise of eternal life and take his place at the table of God's children in heaven. As a reminder of Michael's baptism, I'm going to sprinkle his coffin once again with holy water. Just that time when he became a new creation in Christ, when he was given the pledge of eternal life. And now that he has passed from this world to the next, may that pledge of eternal life become a reality for him. Let us stand and pray. Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our brother Michael, in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, he will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you have bestowed upon Michael in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn towards us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our brother Michael forever. Through the same Christ, our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks.
And in peace, let us take Michael to his place of rest, and as we leave, we'll hear Ave Maria.